So in this video, just what we have seen in the last class, it is an infinite series. So in the infinite series, we have done it under the basic definitions and the convergent, divergent, and also we have started two methods. It is a test of convergence of the series positive terms. So in that we have a two, one is a Cauchy's root test and D elements ratio test. So in that we have started a problem, one problem we did in the last video, which is Cauchy's root test. So in Cauchy's root test, just I'll give a review to do further, because problem we are going to continue under the same topic, which is summation un is a series of positive terms. When you can apply the limit n tends to infinity, the whole power of 1 by n for un, which is will give an answer of finite, then the L value, which is you are having a finite answer, is less than 1, means the given series, that summation un, it is a un, the is a convergent, and if it is a greater than 1, it is a divergent, and equal to 1, the test will fail. Okay, so let me see the another some sample problems which is based on this method. So the second problem, we have to test for convergent. Test for the convergency, summation n is equal to 1 to infinity n plus 1 by n the whole power n squared into 1 by 3 power n. So this is your question. So actually they have directly mentioned it is an infinite series of summation un. In this we are going to test whether it is a convergent or not. So I am going to choose in Cauchy's root test. For that, first you can write it un. What is your un? Un is nothing but n plus 1 by n the whole power n squared into 1 by 3 power of n. So now as per the Cauchy's root test, I need to make it whole power of 1 by n. So complete term n plus 1 by n the whole power n squared into 1 by 3 power n the whole power of 1 by n. So what will happen? You can apply, what is that power of n? You can apply first one, n plus 1 by n the whole power n I will get, and the second one I will get 1 by 3, because that n will get cancelled, right? So now I can apply as per, so as per what is that Cauchy's root test limit, what is that n tends to infinity un the whole power of 1 by n, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity n plus 1 by n the whole power n into 1 by 3, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity, I can simplify this, n by n will be 1 plus 1 by n whole power n into 1 by 3. Why we have written? Because since we have already seen some standard result, what is that? The second one, limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n the whole power n, we can directly write that answer. So using that I can write it, this is nothing but e into 1 by 3, it is nothing but 2.7 into 1 by 3, which is equal to, what is that? Your answer is 0.906. So since what is that limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n the whole power n must be equal to e, for that reason we have chosen it as directly or substituted. Now you can see this is nothing but which is less than of 1. So you can tell un is, what is that? It is a convergent. So this is a convergent for the given question. So clear now? Now we'll go for your next another sample question. So your third problem, you have to test the convergent of your un is equal to n squared by 2n. So test the convergency. So the question, it may be to test the convergency or by use your Cauchy's root test. So what I'm going to choose here, because a simple one I can choose the Cauchy's root test. So what is that? Your un already has been given, it is n squared by 2 power n. So now you can go with un the whole power 1 by n. So it is n squared by 2 power n the whole power of 1 by n. So how it will be, the n will get cancelled, I'll get n power of 1 by n by, what is that, I will get only for 2, clear? The square, I can write it like this, 2 I have taken outside, 1 by n I have taken inside. So now, as per, what is that, the Cauchy's root test, I can apply the limit n tends to infinity, un the whole power 1 by n, which will give, what is that, limit n tends to infinity, n power 1 by n, the whole squared by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 into, this part also we have seen, as per the note, it's standard result, limit n tends to infinity, n power 1 by n, which will give equal to 1. So you can use that, I can write it, this is nothing but as an 1 square, which is equal to 1. That is 1 by 2, which is less than 1. So therefore, here also, by what is that, Cauchy's root test, given un is convergent. It's clear? One more sample problem we will see it under this before into your next method. So the fourth problem, what is the question? You have to test it, summation n varies from 1 to infinity 1 plus 1 by root n the whole power minus n the whole power of 3 by 2. You have to test the convergent. So let me consider, what is here un, when I am writing un because of a minus, I can write 1 by 1 plus 1 by root n the whole power of, what is that, I have a term, it is n power of 3 by 2, right? So now I can take it as a power, un the whole power of 1 by n, which is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by root n the whole power of, this n power 3 by 2, I can write it n into n power 1 by 2. So by n will get cancelled, I'll get it is only root n will be a left out, right? So now we are going to apply your, what is that, Cauchy's root test. As per Cauchy's root test, limit n tends to infinity, un the whole power 1 by n, which is equal to, limit n tends to infinity, what is the term of your un? So un is 1 by 1 plus, I have a term as, what is it, 1 by root n. So 1 by root n and the whole power, the denominator power root n, I have a term. So now how you can do, as per the standard result, is there any possible? I have a standard result, 3 result is that. So here I have a term 1 plus 1 by n. So I can use it, that result, n tends to infinity. What is that? 1 plus 1 by n, the whole power of n must be equal to, since we know. So instead of n, I have a term here. What is that? Instead of n, I have a root n. So substitute that, I'll have a limit n tends to infinity, un the whole power 1 by n, which will give limit n tends to infinity. So I have a term, only it is there in the denominator, right? So that complete denominator term will have, it is an e, right? So that you will be having a term 1 by e, clear? So there is no n term. The answer is 1 by e, which is equal to, the term is 0.367. So which is less than or greater than, it is a less than of 1. So therefore, I can conclude that the given un is a convergent.